All right. Monokuma foul, number three.
So, regarding Toph's death, I wonder if he died before he threw me, or perhaps it was after? We already know what order they were killed in.
Damn. Come on, Makoto. Don't scare me like that. Makes me think something's weird going on. I should have went through. I was like kind of iffy on that one, but.
Toph's death. I wonder if he died before he threw me, or perhaps it was after. We already know what order they were killed in. Taka came last.
What makes you say that?
Because of the numbering of the Justice Hammers.
It's true that Ifumi was killed with Justice Hammer 3, while Taka's death came from a swing of Justice Hammer 4.
See? So it's obvious Taka came after.
That those hammers were out of place anyways, because the bigger the hammer, the more powerful it is. Ifumi obviously would take more to kill than Taka.
Death,
so why would you kill Ifumi with the smaller hammer?
Ifumi, or perhaps it was after? We already know what order they were killed in. Taka came last.
What makes you say that?
Because of the
numbering of the Justice Hammer.
That's not it either?
Shoot.
Alright.
So, regarding Taka's death, I wonder if he died before he threw me, or perhaps it was after? We already know what order they were killed in. Taka came last.
What makes you say that?
Because of the numbering of the Justice Hammers.
It's true that Ifumi was killed with Justice Hammer 3, while Taka's death came from a swing of Justice Hammer 4.
See? So it's obvious Taka came after.
Okay, so apparently there is a way. I don't know how to do this. Let's see. There is a way to change what the thing is. Forward fire truth bullet flashback. Is it holding Y? Concentrate? Not that. Silencer. I guess we'll try holding Y, I guess. There's a way to,
or perhaps it was after,
change that.
We already know what order they were killed in.
Oh yeah.
Taka came last.
What makes you say that?
Because of the numbering of the Justice Hammers.
It's true.
I didn't even know that was an ability we had. That had to have been something that we got introduced to on one of the other trials. And obviously, I don't play this straight through, so of course I'm going to forget about stuff like that. But I honestly don't remember when it was, because then when you go back through, it's still there.
Regarding Taka's death, I wonder if he died before he.
I would have never figured that out. I ever.
We already know what order they.
Like, I would have never figured that out. Ever. We would have been stuck here. Like, I probably wouldn't have been able to finish the game.
Hold on. There's no reason to assume that the hammers were used in the same order as their numbers.
Back. You're going to need a bigger hammer to kill Ifumi. Period.
If anything, that's just another way the killer tried to disguise their actions.
So you're saying the culprit wanted us to think the hammers were used in order, but in reality, Taka was killed before Ifumi? Okay then, let's see the proof.
Probably that walk hammer, right? What? What? Oh, wristwatch. Okay. Now it's pretty
easy. Now I understand.
Once we figured out what it was. That one that they did the last time, with it being schizo?
Taka's wristwatch.
That was petty.
See? Look. It broke with the hands pointing just past 6 o'clock.
It must have gotten broken when he was attacked by the killer. Because...
I'm not about to keep reading all this. Y'all already got the voice actors talking.
So
just let them talk.
After 6 last night, then he must have been attacked around 6 this morning.
And that would be his official time of death.
But if that's true, then he was killed well before Hifumi.
And before Celeste was attacked this morning.
That's right. Taka was killed before any of the other incidents took place.
That simple fact slipped past all of us. We made the wrong assumption about the order of events, all because of those justice hammers.
That's exactly why the culprit wrote the numbers on each hammer and had them increase in size. That way, when we saw how they were used in each incident, we'd easily make that wrong assumption.
Now, if Taka was killed around 6, then everyone's alibis for his murder go out the window. Because when he was killed, we hadn't met up in the dining hall yet.
May be true in the case of Taka's murder. But all of our alibis still hold true for Hifumi's death.
That's right. With him, at least, we're all safe.
Woohoo! Now? What was that?
It came from downstairs. It must have been.
Hifumi, he's in a nurse's office. This is bad. Come on. We have to go back.
When we heard Hifumi screaming,
they just can't leave me alone with Reed,
except
huh?
Except for Hiro and Kyoko. Then we all ran down to the nurse's office, and that's where we found his body.
That's totally true. We're all in the clear.
Oh, I know. They must have recorded him screaming on a tape or something, then played it later on.
If that's true, where's the tape?
I don't know.
Don't just go making stuff up.
Anyway, we all have rock solid alibis for when we heard Hifumi scream.
Every time, he asks nothing.
Since all of us were there together, clearly none of us could have killed him.
And it does not stop there. There was also the moment when we discovered his body had disappeared. When his body vanished from the nurse's office, Hina and I were in the bathroom together, while everyone else was in the equipment room, correct? And then there's the disappearance of Taka's body from the equipment room. At that time, we were all gathered together in the nurse's office because of Hifumi going missing.
Well, don't forget, I was passed out in the equipment room the whole time.
Wait, then what if Genocide Jill did it? She could have dragged Taka's body out of there right then.
Even if she could pull that off, there's no way she could have done the same with Hifumi's body.
Exactly.
Because, as we just established, she was passed out in the equipment room when his body disappeared.
Besides, I didn't do either of them anyway.
In other words, it is impossible that any of us could have killed Hifumi or moved either of their bodies. On the other hand, Hiro and Kyoko had disappeared, so they most certainly could have done those things.
So what now, Kyoko?
For now, we can't get fixated on who did it, or we'll just keep going around in circles. So instead of who, I propose we start talking about how. In particular, I think we need to figure out how Hifumi's body got moved.
That's true. We searched everywhere, but we couldn't figure out how to explain his body disappearing.
That's because he got up and
according to what
himself.
Celeste said...
We could have not been gone for more than a minute or two, though. So then the killer was able to get in and move Hifumi's body in such a short time?
It would seem so.
His body apparently disappeared in the 1 minute her and Hina took their eyes off of it.
I've got it. Celeste killed Byakuya. Celeste killed Byakuya. and was using Hifumi to have it clear, covered up. Hifumi wasn't really dead. I still don't think he's dead, honestly.
But to carry that much weight from the first floor up to the third, in that...
Oh, man, yeah! There's no way! It'd be impossible!
Well, what if I told you there was a way to make the impossible possible?
What? How?
If the dead body were to move itself.
Facts! Brains, my guy! Brains!
Moved on its own?
No! Not another... No!
I don't think it has anything to do with the occult. I think what she's implying is, we thought Hifumi was dead, but perhaps in reality, he was still alive.
Alive?
Are you saying Hifumi wasn't carried out of the nurse's office, but simply walked out on his own?
But I mean, we found his body. He was dead.
Perhaps he was simply playing dead.
That it isn't possible.
The idea that Hifumi was still alive. Is it really possible? Yes. The little handkerchief. Broken whip rock. What was that again?
Are you saying that when we first found Hifumi in the nurse's office, there's a chance he was actually still alive?
No. It is impossible. Hifumi was dead, without a doubt.
And you know that how?
No, he wouldn't.
Surely you heard the body discovery announcement along with the rest of us. Hifumi's dead body had been found.
Shoot!
Maybe the announcement was intended to signal someone else.
I didn't mean to do that. I meant to shoot him.
Are you saying that when we first found Hifumi in the nurse's office, there's a chance he was actually still alive?
No. Hifumi was dead, and you know that surely you've heard the body of Hifumi's dead, and that is what...
Are we really so sure? Maybe the announcement was...
Someone else's discovery.
Shoot!
Huh?
Are you saying that when
we first found him,
there's a chance he was actually still alive?
No. It is impossible. Hifumi was dead, without a doubt.
And you know that how?
Surely you've heard the body discovery announcement along with the rest of us. Maybe the
announcement
to signal someone else's discovery.
Are you saying that when we first found Hifumi in the nurse's office, there's a chance he was actually still alive?
No. It is impossible. Hifumi was dead.
And you know that how?
Surely you've heard the body discovery announcement along with the rest.
Maybe it's the last one, but I'm gonna try this one again. Of course. There it is, okay.
No, it's wrong.
I hate having to, like, I hope that they cut that shit out. Like, I'm not trying to have to fuse bullets every time and figure out which one it goes to.
Really intended for Hifumi?
Of course it was. The announcement played right after we discovered his body.
Maybe. But that was also the same time that Taka's body was found.
That's right. It wasn't long after finding his body that we heard the announcement.
So there's a good chance we've made a mistake in there somewhere. I think we've confused whether the announcement was for Hifumi or Taka.
First of all, if two bodies had been found, there really should have been two announcements.
Maybe Monokuma simply got lazy and rolled them together into one.
What do you say, Monokuma? Any comment?
Well, it's a very sensitive issue, so I can't go into too much detail. But what I can say about the body discovery announcement is that... it's only broadcast when three or more people find a dead body for the first time.
That didn't answer our question, man. We're asking if you're a lazy bum.
No, actually, that was plenty.
Huh?
He said it's only broadcast when a body is discovered for the first time. which means even if we find the same body again later, he won't make the announcement again. If that's true, then why was the announcement made again later on?
Huh? Later on?
Exactly. We heard the body discovery announcement twice.
The second body discovery announcement, the first time it played, was when we found each body in the nurse's office in the equipment room. And the second time was when both bodies were rediscovered? No. Is that it? Why would the announcement play? Actually, that's true.
Shoot!
I don't remember when it played again, honestly. Of course, it's the first one. Every time you don't go with the first answer, it's always the first answer.
I got it! We heard it a second time in the repository when we rediscovered the two bodies.
Not reading it.
It didn't seem weird at the time, but it contradicts what Monokuma just told us, doesn't it?
Exactly. If we were actually rediscovering both bodies, the announcement shouldn't have played.
But in reality, when the two dead bodies were rediscovered, one of them was actually being discovered for the first time.
So when we found Hifumi the first time in the nurse's office, he wasn't actually dead yet. Meaning he wasn't actually found dead until we came upon him in the repository.
And even then, he woke back up, so was he really dead?
There's one other thing that leads me to believe he was still alive in the nurse's office.
That handkerchief, finally?
Because he was super good at playing dead! Bada bing, bada boom!
That is the worst logic I have ever heard. But honestly, I do not think there's anything that can prove he was still alive.
Okay, then. Let's take another look at the events surrounding the discovery of his body. Then it should become clear whether he was really alive or not.
This whole thing is pointless.
There has to be proof that shows Hifumi was still alive. I have to find it and show everyone. Can we start with these two bullets? Can we just go into the thing so I can just select the handkerchief? Like, I'm tired of these truth bullet things because y'all keep trying to make me have
so
to fuse them.
So here's one thing we do know. The first time we found Hifumi's body was in the nurse's office. And then, while me and Celeste were in the bathroom, his body disappeared.
And the next time we saw his body, it was in the repository.
But when you compare his body before being moved and his body after being moved, other than the change in how it was positioned, there was no notable difference.
They tried to get me with that. Bitch. You ain't about to get me. Not again. I can't keep getting these damn things wrong.
In fact, there was one clear difference between Hifumi in the nurse's office and the repository. His glasses. That fact alone proves that he was only playing dead in the beginning.
Perhaps you'd like to fill the rest of us in?
When we found Hifumi in the nurse's office, his glasses were covered with blood. But when we found him again later in the repository, they were spotless.
And he's sweating bullets. That
and
man, I don't think he did.
I found the items used to wipe them clean in the nurse's office trash can. It was a glasses cleaning cloth featuring a certain cartoon mascot.
His favorite.
One look at the bloodstain on the cloth should make things clear. This piece of cloth was used to wipe Hifumi's glasses clean. And the mascot on the cloth is the same one that's on the digital camera, right? And whose digital camera was it? Hifumi's, of course. Oh.
The character was Princess Piggles. From Demon Angel Pretty Pudgy Princess, I think.
I highly doubt anyone but Hifumi would have brought something like this to school.
I see your point. And the only people here who wear glasses are
I wouldn't be caught dead using a tacky piece of garbage like that.
A few tissues is all I need to keep my glasses clean.
Oh yeah, I forgot they do wear glasses.
Then there's no question. It belonged to Hifumi.
So what you're saying is... What exactly?
This man.
What I'm saying is, the blood on his glasses was wiped away using his own glasses cleaning cloth.
Even if that is true, it does not mean he wiped the blood off himself.
But who would benefit from a clean pair of glasses other than the glasses' owner?
That's a good point.
Well, it must have been him, right?
So let's assume that Hifumi was still alive in the nurse's office. He pretends to be dead. Then when he's alone, he wipes his glasses clean so he can see. Then he stands up and walks out on his own 2 feet. And with that, the impossible task of moving his copious corpse becomes possible.
But then, if he was just pretending to be dead... What was with all that blood? Was it paint or something?
The fridge in the nurse's office contains packs of blood for emergencies. He probably used one of those.
He figured if he was gonna play dead, he should go all out. So he just dumped it everywhere! But he got crazy with it and had to wipe his glasses off when he was done. God, what an idiot!
And if Hifumi was still alive at that point, the disappearance of Taka's body is easily explained. It should be perfectly obvious who must have moved Taka's corpse.
Hifumi!
My God! It could only have been Hifumi.
While we were all gathered in the nurse's office, he went to the equipment room and took Taka's body.
That also explains how the door to the repository got locked.
The door was locked?
Well, after the bodies disappeared, we all went looking for him, right? So me and Sakura headed for the repository. But when we got there, the door was locked.
And the repository door can only be locked from the inside. Which means when Hina and Sakura got to the repository, someone was already inside.
And it could only have been Hifumi, who just finished stashing Taka's body there.
He convinced us all he was dead. And when he saw his chance, he dragged Taka's body to the repository. So, Hifumi wasn't just another victim in this case. He was one of the assailants.
But that means he took part in the murders.
I just can't believe it.
If you're having trouble, would you like me to show you one more piece of evidence?
There's more?
This
oh,
man.
Absolutely.
He adds absolutely no value.
Pointing to his involvement has yet to be revealed. You know what I'm talking about, right, Makoto?
The thing that Hifumi stole from Taka.
Talking about the note Hifumi had hidden away, aren't you?
Hidden note?
That's right. We found it stuffed in his pants.
What? In his pants?
Yes, his pants.
Okay, well, forget about the pants for now. Take a look at what the note says.
I found a hole maybe we can use to escape. Monokuma can't find out, so don't tell anyone for now. Let's meet in the equipment room at 6 a.m.
That's the note I was telling you about. The one that told me where to go. Huh? Wait, this one's a little different. In my note, it said...
1 a.m.
Monokuma can't find out, so don't tell anyone else for now. Let's meet in the rec room at 1 a.m.
See, then this note isn't the same one Hiro got.
It's not the same?
In other words... The killer got in touch with another person besides Hiro. And that person could only have been... I got it! That's right! Taka! The killer used this note to draw out Taka and murder him!
Hello! Over here! Objection! Objection! I don't really understand what's going on, but Hifumi had that letter, right? So whoever wrote it wasn't drawing out TikTok, they were drawing out Huffy!
Just to be clear, TikTok is Taka and Huffy is Hifumi, right?
Ugh! Yes! Why must you ruin it every time?
Man, Genocide Jack is seriously scary, but still, I can't let her get to me. It's the piece of paper he had ripped in his hand. Obviously, he was holding it.
Puppy had the note, right? Then the person it was intended for must have been Puppy!
But remember what the note said. What time did it say to meet?
6 a.m.
The time doesn't matter! The note has nothing to do with TikTok!
Nothing to do with TikTok. It was Taka. Oh, yes, it does.
And the person it was, it must have been Taki.
But remember, what time did it say to meet?
6 a.m.
The time doesn't matter. The note has nothing to do with TikTok.
No, it's wrong.
No, there absolutely is a connection.
What the hell are you talking about?
The note said to meet at 6 a.m., which is the same time Taka was murdered.
What? What the hell are you talking about?
You've already proven that using his wristwatch. But there's more. Look where the note says to meet. The equipment room, right?
Which is where Taka was killed.
Oh.
So, Taka was murdered at both the time and place written in the note. I think that should be plenty to show that this note was definitely meant for Taka.
Well, when you put it like that...
No further objections!
Then someone used that note to trick Taka. Just the same as me. The culprit really is a cold-blooded monster. Telling people they found a way out.
But if they gave the note to Taka, what was Hifumi doing with it?
Stuck down his pants, no less!
Most likely, Hifumi stole it off Taka's corpse after he died.
He stole it?
Where's your covering proof? Up the person.
Go ahead, show us.
You know, I'm tired of having to do everything for these people. Y'all figure it out!
I got it! When I searched Taka's body, I saw that his lifeless hand was gripping a small scrap of paper. If I'm right about this, the sheet of paper this piece came from is... I knew it! It fits perfectly with the note we found hidden on Hifumi!
Then Taka's scrap and Hifumi's note...
Yup, they're from the same piece of paper.
Hifumi had the note meant for Taka, while Taka's corpse still grasped a small piece of that note. There is only one way to explain it.
Taka died clutching the note. Hifumi tried to free the note from his death grip, leaving behind only one small scrap. Did I get all that right?
That means Hifumi knew the note was
Did
important.
I get all that right?
Yes, girl.
Exactly.
Now we need to get you recovered
Which
from the Marvel 100.
Whoa. Yeah. After seeing all this, Hifumi was super involved in this whole thing for sure. In fact, he was behind the whole thing! In fact, he's still alive!
Sorry, no. When we found him in the repository, Hifumi was truly and completely dead. The second body discovery announcement proves that.
Okay, so they do know if it's real or not. Okay.
Whoever did is the mastermind, the true killer.
He was
Celeste!
In the repository. So he must have been killed not long after transporting Taka's body.
So, he must have been killed after Taka's body vanished, but before we found both bodies in the repository.
During that time, we'd all split up and were searching for Taka's missing body. In other words, during that time, none of us have alibis.
Wait, but me and Sakura were together.
Stop trying to steal the spotlight, you stupid walrus!
Damn.
Who are you calling a walrus?
Anyway, when they were killed bothers me, too. But there's something that's been bothering me even more.
Alright, what you
and
about to say?
And what might that be?
The weapon they used to kill Hifumi!
The weapon?
Yeah, because, I mean, According to the Monokuma file, the way Taka and Hifumi were killed was almost the same, with them having similar fractures and all. But Justice Hammer 3 and 4 were still laying around in the nurse's office and equipment room, right? So if Hifumi was killed in the repository, the culprit would have had to grab one of the hammers, kill Hifumi.
That's why it was washed! Okay, you finally add some to the story. About time. Jesus.
Be seriously risky for him?
I'm surprised. It seems there's some semblance of a brain knocking around.
Exactly, like Jesus Christ.
Hell yeah, it's packed in there good and tight.
He's right though. I don't understand it either. The Monokuma file makes it clear that they were killed using similar instruments. But if the hammers were already laying around those other rooms...
So the question is, how could the culprit have gotten their hands on either of the hammers? Personally, I haven't a clue. So which hammer was used to attack Celeste? Number one or number two?
Those were accounted for in other rooms too. And I don't think either one is big enough to kill someone.
Is it not possible they used a different weapon?
I don't think it is possible. They were both killed with the same kind of thing, right?
So then, what was used to kill Hifumi?
The weapon that actually was used to kill Hifumi. The whole picture surrounding this case won't become clear until I figure that out. Somehow, I have to find the truth. We already know it. Stop doing these truth bullet sections. Let me just click the evidence.
What was used to kill Hifumi? Was it Justice Hammer 3? Maybe Justice Hammer 4?
Well, whatever it was, there's one thing we have to figure out. How was the culprit able to move around so freely with the weapon? How did nobody witness them carrying it?
Sounds like a Justice Hammer 5 is about to make its appearance! Check out murdergear.com/hammertime for more info!
Well, one thing seems pretty clear. The murder weapon had to be one of the Justice Hammers.
Nope, and, that's not it.
That's about it.
Maybe it's that one? I'm thinking it's either what Genocide Jill just said or what he said. I'm gonna try Genocide Jill thing first. So it gotta be what, Hero said.
What was used was it just to
be? It could be that as well.
One thing's the murder weapon.
No, it's wrong.
The murder weapon wasn't a justice hammer at all. No, it was something completely different.
But seriously? A different...
Specifically, a hammer from the repository. The killer could have easily used that to kill Hifumi. Now, all the hammers in the repository were covered in flecks of grit and debris. But for some reason, one of them had been scrubbed clean.
Huh?
And the reason it had been scrubbed clean was most likely because it was used to commit murder. If the hammer got covered in Hifumi's blood, of course they'd have to clean it off.
Which is why that door was locked, to give him more time.
I'd also like to point out that the repository has all kinds of hammers. Yep. Big ones, small ones, and even some flat mallet-like ones. I think whoever made the Justice Hammers used those as a basis for their design.
If that's true, that would explain the Monokuma file's note about the wounds being similar.
So Hifumi moved Taka's body to the repository, where someone then used a hammer to kill him.
Whoever did that is the true killer. The one Hifumi was working with. And the one who betrayed him. Hold on a moment. I still think it's strange to assume someone was working together with him. The way the graduation rule works, there is no benefit to helping someone else carry out a murder.
No, unless they're so super
the
obsessed with you. Which is another reason why I'm thinking it's her.
Ludicrous. We talked about this, did we not?
We did talk about there wouldn't be any reason for anyone to work together. At least, that's what we thought at first, but... What we got now? Spotless hammer. Again?
Based on the rules that have been laid out for us, even if more than one person is complicit in the murder, only the one who actually carried out the act can graduate and survive. Assuming the rule holds true, it is simply impossible that two people work together on this.
That is how the rule was explained to us.
But that only really applies if there's one murder, right? In this case, however, there were two murders.
I think I got a...
Based on the rules that have been...
Because that spotless hammer has nothing to do
can graduate and... Assuming the rule holds true, it is simply impossible that two people work together on this.
That is how the rule was explained to us.
But that only really applies if there's one murder, right? In this case, however, there were two murders.
Based on the rules that have been laid out for us, even if more than one person is complicit in the murder, only the one who actually carried out the act can graduate and survive. Assuming the rule holds true, it is...
No, it's wrong!
Big brains! I'm tired of you, Spike, trying to get me. I'm tired of it. You having me, you making me have to think on a higher level, so I've unlocked my brain to think higher. Just so I'm not continuously getting frustrated since you want to keep throwing shit like this at me.
What do you mean?
If there's only been one murder, then yes, the idea of an accomplice isn't really worth considering. Naturally, if only one person can be saved per murder, an accomplice has no risk versus reward benefit.
Risk versus reward benefit?
The payoff for working together. The reward that balances out the risk of taking part in a scheme. There's no point in being someone's accomplice if there's no benefit to you. However, if there were some potential mutual reward for the risk, then cooperation becomes possible.
You're saying that two people could act as each other's accomplices to commit two separate murders?
I think that's what the true killer told Hifumi. They would each have an accomplice for their crime. And based on the case's events, Hifumi would have been the first one to act, murdering Taka. Mm-hmm. They made him carry out the first murder so he couldn't back out of helping them later on.
So in this case, there wasn't one single person committing multiple murders. Instead, each person killed someone, creating two separate
incidents. This game is crazy.
And
this game is really crazy.
Like one person, because that's how the true killer designed it to look.
And that's what I was saying, like in one of the previous episodes when I was talking about how Monokuma was like with his words, what he was saying about finding the true mastermind, because they once again brought up like an accomplice, because it was two people that they got discovered killed. And Monokuma was talking about finding the true mastermind. Is what you're looking for. And I'm like thinking, why would you say that, right? If there's one person killed two people, why would you be talking about the true mastermind unless there are more than one person involved? Which is why I was thinking it was Kyoko, Celeste, and Ao, just because just how they were acting, it just was weird as hell. But now we know for a fact it has to be Celeste, because Hifumi is the only person in there that's head over heels for her. Like, literally head over heels for her. So, it has to be her.
Individual, a similar weapon used in each crime, disappearing bodies. By creating one seamless set of circumstances, they made it look like one person was behind it all.
The mastermind picked their target and managed to convince him to go along with their plan. And then, to avoid the no accomplices rule, they simply killed their accomplice.
Yep.
Which, if true, means that betraying Hifumi was part of the plan from the very beginning.
That's just awful. How could anyone be so cruel?
You think so? I can't help but admire its cunning. Still, their choice of accomplice seems odd.
The effort made to convince the two murders were the same. That was the main characteristic this whole time. Kyoko must have noticed that fact from the very beginning, which is why she said not to look at this as a series of connected events, but entirely separate incidents. Kyoko really is amazing, although, when you think about it, she's almost too amazing. Like, It's almost unnatural how good she is at it.
I understand how an accomplice could be involved. But then, who was the one pulling Hifumi's strings?
Celeste!
That's problem numero uno right now!
The true killer manipulated Hifumi to carry out a number of actions and in the end murdered him. In the debates up till now, the way the case has unfolded, when you consider all that, there's really only one person who seems to fit.